Hi everyone.
हेलो सर।
Are you able to see my screen?
हेलो सर, गुड इवनिंग। यस
Yes,
सर, यस सर,
हाँ
यस
जी।
सर,
गुड इवनिंग सर।
यस सर।
Hi everyone and good morning and good evening to everyone. So my name is Kishore. I have total 10 plus years of experience, okay, in training. As I'm currently working as well as giving this online training. Okay, today actually we are conducting Salesforce Lightning online training. Okay. Yeah, let me start for today's session. First of all, why we have to go for Lightning? We already have the classic version earlier, but nowadays each and every company are started doing their projects into Lightning. Why we have to learn Lightning? What is the main advantages? Why the companies are moving their project from classic to Lightning? Okay, for example, actually whoever already clients built their projects in classic, nowadays they were migrating from classic to Lightning. Nowadays each and every companies or clients are want to implement their projects with the Lightning. Why? What are the more advantages? Okay, we have seen all these details. Okay, today's demonstration. See, before going to our Lightning session, okay, make sure you have two mandatory things. First of all, everyone have their own org for practicing purpose. Okay, or you have to be maintain your sandbox, or you have to be keep your free developer org. Okay, another thing is actually once you have org and everything, make sure you have to be create domain. Domain is mandatory to create any Lightning component in your org. Without domain, you cannot create your component inside your Salesforce. Okay. In regular session, how we can create domain, how we can register, we will see in detail on live. Okay. These two are mandatory steps to create. Okay. To create any Lightning component. Okay. The next step will be what is Lightning component framework? See, Lightning, right? Salesforce Lightning. Salesforce Lightning is a component framework. What is it actually? Okay, why it is somewhat demand inside the Salesforce? Means, see, the Salesforce Lightning component framework, the mainly useful for to develop dynamic mobile apps, mobile or web apps in Lightning experience. Okay, as well as this Lightning component framework is followed by the single page application architecture. What is single page application architecture? All functionality we can see in a single view. Okay, here actually, for example, the thing is actually if we want to show like naturally 5 to 10 different object information in a single page, you can do that without writing much code. Actually, we have to be simply drag and drop component like that. That is the reason Lightning component framework is a single page application architecture. The main use of the particular Lightning component framework is to build dynamic mobile or web apps in Lightning experience. Okay, this particular Lightning is completely based on HTML5, JavaScript, and CSS, and followed by the MVC design pattern. What is MVC? The Salesforce having type of architecture is MVC, means Model View Controller. M is nothing but M is nothing but model. View is nothing but UI. C is nothing but controller to build business logic. By using this Lightning framework, we can do everything. We can display the data, we can build the logic, then as well as actually we have to be set data model kind of thing. Everything we can follow that. That is the reason Lightning is followed by MVC design pattern. And also Lightning component is strongly coupled with Apex server side calls. You know, actually the data will be storing into object, right? Means actually we have to be make connection from your Lightning component to your database. Okay, in this case actually you have to be maintain middle layer is Apex controller. That is the reason this Lightning component is strongly coupled with Apex for server side call. Okay, here actually whenever you have to be make server side call and everything, but the data transformation will be happen in the form of JSON. What is JSON? Okay, you know, actually you are giving request from UI to your database. Okay, how the request will be cached from UI and then giving to your database in middleware. Okay, actually you have to be maintain some middle layer. Middle layer is nothing but here Mapex controller. Okay, giving request to database. Once the database, then again you have to be take its response. The request response means here the data transformation will be happen in the form of JSON. What is JSON? Is nothing but JSON is nothing but Java Standard Object Notation. It is completely lightweight application. Lightweight. See, actually most of any integrations, okay, like some REST integration, everything will be built based on the JSON. Why it is JSON means the request response. It is so faster. That is the reason all integration, all mobile application are using the JSON only for data transformation. Okay, but in Lightning also each and every data, like to transfer data from UI to database, then again taking response from database to UI. The data transformation will be happen in the form of JSON. Why? Because request response wise is it's so fast. Okay, here actually another thing is here. Okay, it support means here Lightning components is completely flexible for your desktop, mobile, or tablet. Means you have to write code only once, but the same code will be flexible to your device. Earlier, actually, whenever you build any project and classic, okay, the UI is not flexible to your tablet, mobile. Okay, the classic version is only flexible to desktop. Okay, once you have built any project on classic, the client cannot use the application properly on the mobile device. They cannot use on tablet. They're facing a lot of difficulty. But here, whenever used to build your project inside the Lightning, okay, the client's customer start using on any device. Okay, whatever screen you build, the screen automatically resize based on your device. Okay, you can use same code, but it will display the component based on your screen size. Okay, this is the main advantage of Lightning. That is the reason most and clients or customer start using the Lightning. Okay, the classic will take lot of time to load, but this Lightning will give the quicker response. Okay, as well as it is flexible to device. Okay, the Lightning is flexible to any device. Lightning framework is built on Aura framework. What is an Aura? Aura is an open source framework developed by salesforce.com. okay, what framework? Okay, so what framework here actually to build on this particular Lightning means Lightning component has built on top of Aura framework. Aura is an open source. Open source means actually it is free of cost. There is no need to pay any extra money to Salesforce to get the Aura framework. Okay, this is complete about Lightning framework. Then we have to be seen why we have to be go for Salesforce Lightning. Okay, these all are main advantages. Okay, we already have classic version, but here why we have to be go for Lightning? Just a minute guys, 1 minute. Sorry guys. Okay, why should go for Salesforce Lightning? First one is avoid server calls. Do you know what is server calls? Whenever you have to be make any particular Mapex controller to your page, that is nothing but server call. Okay, because of you already UI, but here your database and everything will be stored into object, right? But here if you want to get your object data on your page, make sure you have to be helped with controller. You are making some call. Within the call, you are performing your SQL operation, DML operation, means you are hitting the database, right? That is nothing but server call. Okay, see, but here actually whenever you can go for Salesforce Lightning, okay, there is no need much server calls. The main advantage of Salesforce Lightning that we can avoid many server calls. while working with lightning component. Okay, the reason behind is the Salesforce Lightning has inside JS controller, okay, JavaScript controller. By using this JavaScript controller, we can manipulate the data into controller and display as per our need the data and everything. No need to go each and every time to FS controller. The Lightning component has already as linked up with JavaScript controller. You can manage your complete data. No need to go for Apex class controller calls. Okay. Whenever you can go for Lightning, the first advantage is we can avoid multiple server calls. Another feature will be lazy loading to increase performance. What does that mean? Another awesome feature which loads and display particular component. Okay. Particular component. Okay, actually, whenever user to load, not like unlike Visual Workspace. For example, actually, whenever you create any particular record, the data will not display automatically on UI. Make sure you have to be refresh the whole page, then only the data get display. But in particular Lightning, if you have update any component, without loading your page, the data automatically reflect on fly. Is it clear? For example, okay, you have some account, you have a child object of contact, right? Okay. For example, here having some formula field or any validation triggers or something will be there, right? Whenever you create any particular contact, if you want to update any calculation in the parent object, once you create the child object, make sure you have to be refresh the page in Classic. But in Lightning, no need. The data will be reflect on fly. Because of lazy loading, it increases the performance and data will be reflect on the fly. Okay. Another one is faster development. Okay. See, actually, whenever you can go for Classic Visual Workspace component, we have to be write lot of code by using tags and everything, right? Actually, if you want to more some user friendly UI kind of thing, you have to be apply lot of you have to be apply lot of CSS, HTML and everything. The top two here actually, the UI is only flexible. The particular UI is only flexible your desktop only, not flexible for mobile and everything. Okay, but it will take lot of time to build the UI. But here actually, whenever come to Lightning, it empowers team to work faster with out of the box component seamlessly with desktop and mobile. Desktop and mobile device. Here the Salesforce Lightning will provide out of the box feature, means they will provide some kind of some SLDS as well as here. Okay, they will provide some tags, some Aura tags. Based on that, we will build our complete UI very quickly, very faster. Okay, it won't take much time. Okay, another thing is, another some advantage is device aware and cross browser capability. What is that? Means app uses responsive design and provides enjoyable user experience. Means whenever you build any particular component, the particular component, the size will be flexible automatically for any device. Okay. The users can use their application within their desktop or mobile or tablet. Okay. Another one is Lightning App Builder. What is this Lightning App Builder? In Salesforce, we created some apps, right? Apps. App is nothing but collection of tabs and everything. But in Salesforce also, if you want to create the app, make sure we have to create App Builder. Okay. Here actually we have to be build complete application without writing single line of code using out of the box. By using out of the box component, once you create Lightning App Builder, we can simply drag and drop components. Okay. Means actually what component you want to display on the particular screen, you have to be drag and drop. No need to write any code kind of thing. Another one is event-driven architecture. This is component event. What is mean of event-driven architecture? Event-driven architecture is decoupling between two components. Means actually, if you want to transfer data from one component to another component, there is no relationship between two components. But here actually, if we want to transfer data from one component to another component, okay, actually we can do easily with you can do some easily with event driven architecture. Means you can transfer data from one component to another component. Another one is SLDS. What is mean of SLDS? SLDS nothing but Salesforce Lightning Design System that gives power style of your component. Means no need to write, apply any some HTML tags and everything. Whenever you have open Lightning Design System, the Salesforce, by default, they give lot of example with UI. You simply do copy paste. Just you have to be apply logic. The screen look and feel is very rich. Okay, no need to write any some manual HTML code, manual CSS code and everything. By using this as SLDS, you have to be apply rich look and feel on your component. Okay. Some another main advantage is avoid view state error. Okay, do you know mean of view state error? If you have really worked on your Salesforce class, you will get to know what is mean of view state error. View state error is nothing but you cannot display much data on your Visual Force space. Whenever you build your page on Classic, you cannot display much data on your Visual Force space because of Visual Force space will be maintained the page size 135 KB. Whenever the size will be increased more than 135 KB, by default the Salesforce throws an error of view state error. But here, whenever you build your project or application in Lightning, you can display large amount of data. You never get view state error. That is the advantage of Lightning. Okay. Another one is Lightning Out. Lightning Out is nothing but here actually. Okay, you can use your Lightning component to outside of your application. Okay, means actually. Okay, the thing is actually once you have built your Lightning component, if you want to use in your Visual Force space, you can do. Visual Force space is classic, right? Okay, if you have built someone is built your complete design and everything in Lightning, but you can use the same page in the Classic. You can do, but by using with the help of Lightning Out. These all are features of Lightning. Is it clear? Do you have any doubts on this? Let me go to one by one in real time examples. If you're not understanding, no need to worry. I will show you what is mean of avoid server calls, what is lazy loading, what is faster development, what is Lightning App Builder, what is event-driven architecture. Okay, everything actually we will see it. Okay, here actually check out of the box component. Okay, even you know whenever you have built your Visual Force space kind of thing, okay, what happened here? Okay, the Visual Force space will by default give some tags, right? Apex page, Apex form, Apex colon page block, Apex colon page block table, Apex colon page block section, Apex data table, like that. Same way, the Lightning will give each and every tag provide in the OOTB means, okay, out of the box. Okay, and they provide each and every tag in detail along with some examples. Okay, let me show you. In Visual Force Classic, you will not get this library. This is what? Component library. You can go to developer.salesforce.com, then docs, you can simply enter component library. Here you will see here, these are Aura, Lightning, right? Okay. Accordation means here something like that means actually, okay. Collapsible icon. For example, if you have any buttons kind of thing, what tags you have to be used? Here you will get the tag. If you want get the button, you can simply copy and paste that. Okay, these are some different variants. This is base. This is okay. This is what neutral. This is brand. This is what brand outline. This is okay. This is what some destructive. This is success. This is error. Like that. These are different variants. these are button. If you want to get any button in your component, you have to be copy paste in your tag. We will see later actually how we can create a component and everything. Here, okay, as a developer, you have to be know what component, what is the use. Most of actually whenever you have work on the Lightning, everything here you can do through copy paste only. I'm telling 70 to 80% of copy paste only, but 20 to 30% you have to be apply logic. Okay, I will show you each and every tag in detail. No need to worry on that. Just I'm giving out of the box means actually how we can see each and every tag inside Lightning. Okay. Here some if else condition or anything here. Okay, if else condition or any some iteration looping kind of thing, how we can achieve, everything is there. Simple. If you want get this view, this is a meter, is a tag like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that meter. You can define modern UI. Simple tag. This is only one tag. Okay, it is completely change the UI. Okay. Okay, it will give more. Okay, the Salesforce Lightning will give modern UI to the customers. Okay, we will see later. Okay, this is what out of the box component. You can see complete collection of Lightning component available in your Salesforce org. Okay, you have to be using this URL. You can see what are tags available inside your component and everything. We will see it. Okay, then here. Okay, Lightning component bundle. See here, whenever you create any Lightning component, each component have, okay, 8 different bundles are there. These are, we can call this bundle. Whenever you create any particular Lightning component, okay, here you will get 8 different bundles. What are those means? Component, controller, helper, style, document, renderer, design, SVG. We will go through that each and everything. Okay, before discussing more and more, we will be go through the each and every bundle. What are the advantages? Okay, I will go through later. First of all, to create any Lightning component, okay, what are the steps we need to be follow inside Salesforce to create any Lightning component? First, you have to be open your developer console. What is developer console? Developer console is Salesforce internal tool. Okay, means actually you have to do all your development activity. Means here actually you can create your Visual Workspace, FS class, Lightning component. You can create your trigger, or you can querying your data and everything you can do through this developer console. Even to create any Lightning component, you have to be open developer console. You can go and click on file, then new, then you have to be click on Lightning component. There you have to be enter your name of the component. Okay, whenever you have enter name of your component, these all are interfaces here, component configurations here. Each and every configuration have different purposes there. First, you will see a Lightning tab is there, Lightning page is there, Lightning record page is there, Lightning community page, Lightning quick action is there. What are those? If you can check this checkbox Lightning page, once you create your Lightning component, that page, okay, actually once you can check this checkbox, then only you can use this component as a tab. You know, tab creation in 5 ways in Salesforce. What are those? Web tab, custom object, Visual Workspace, Lightning component, Lightning application, right? If you want to create your component as a tab, make sure you have to be enabled this checkbox. Means whenever you check this checkbox, one interface automatically add into your component. Whenever this interface is available, then only you can use this component as a tab. Okay, we will discuss later one by one. First of all, I would like to show you how to create a component. To create any component, first of all, you have to be go to your Lightning. Okay, first of all, you have to be go to your developer console. Once you can go to developer console, you have to be go to file, then click on new. There you have to be enter Lightning component. You have to be click on Lightning component. Here you have to be enter your component name. Just I'm entering first component. Here, whenever you have add lightning tab, okay, if you click on submit button, automatically one component will created. Whenever you check this checkbox, okay, lightning tab, automatically one interface will be added. What is that interface? Force colon app possible. Whenever this interface is there, then only you can use this component as a tab. Otherwise, you cannot use. We will go through that each and every checkbox and the purpose. We will see later. Okay, just I'm showing for now how to create a component. Whenever you create a component, this is what component, right? You will see 8 different bundles are there in right side. You will observe these things we can call as component bundle. Whenever you create any particular component, okay, then here automatically the Salesforce defined with 8 different bundles. First one is component, then controller, helper, style, document, then renderer, design, SVG. We will discuss each and everything in detail now. Now we will come and see. This is what the screen denotes. Okay, denotes, right? To create a component, whenever you create a component, you will get the screen. Okay, you have to be enter your component and then description. Description is the main purpose. What is the purpose you create a component? After that, here actually you have to be check this checkbox: lightning tab, lightning page, lightning record page, lightning community page, lightning quick action, like that. Okay, clear? First we will see the component. What is the main purpose of this component? Okay, lightning component, component.xml. The extension will be .xml. What is that? Only require resource in component bundle. Whenever you have create any particular component, these all are option. Whether you can go with this controller, you have to be double click on it, then it will create controller. If you see a controller, then actually if you want go with helper, you have to be double click on it, then here one more helper will get created. Until you have double click on it, the controller will not create, the helper will not create, the style will not create, the document will not create. Only one will create. What is the component? That is the reason the component bundle, okay, the component is only one require resource of your component bundle. What we can do with this component bundle means, by using this component bundle, we can build your complete UI. Clear? UI, what is mean of UI? Can anyone tell?
User interface.
Yeah, UI is nothing but user interface. Okay. Actually, by using this particular component, you can build complete your UI. Okay. The main purpose of this component bundle is to build your complete user interface. Another one is controller. What is controller? Controller is the main purpose of is to build any JavaScript based, means, okay, client side controller means, okay, means actually JavaScript bundle. For example, the thing is actually, if you want to make the connection from your component to your Apex controller to make any call, or you want to get data from your controller to display on UI, you can do by using with the help of controller. This controller is the JavaScript controller, client side controller based on JavaScript to handle the events raised by component. For example, here actually while clicking on the particular button, you want to do some action. In this case, for each and every action, no need to go with server side call. You can simply go with your client side call by using with the help of controller. That is the reason, if you see here, the main advantage is, okay, to avoid server calls, right? First advantage. What is mean of to avoid server calls? No need to go much on actually server side calls. We can avoid by using with the help of component controller, right? JavaScript controller. This is what we are discussing. Controller.js is linked up with this component. Okay. We can do complete your complete to handle complete events based on this controller.js. Okay. For example, actually whenever you click on particular save button, or actually whenever you click on cancel button, for each and every time, no need to go with your Apex controller. You can do all validations to perform your actions, event, okay, within your page itself, with the help of JavaScript controller. okay. See, okay, another, okay, some another one, okay, some another bundle is helper. Clear this one? Component and controller. Another bundle is helper. What is this helper? Helper is also in a JavaScript. It is also handle event. But this JavaScript function can be handled by the another JavaScript. Means here, this controller is there, but some another JavaScript controller is helper. Okay. Here actually you can handle your JavaScript functions from another JavaScript function. Means actually if you want to call any function from this, you can call from this controller only. You cannot call directly from your component. Here there is a structure here, component to controller, from controller to helper. The mainly use this helper as a utility kind of thing. Means actually if you want to reuse one function inside your controller, you can create one method. You can use the particular function inside your controller. Okay, no need to write your code again and again in your controller. You can write only once. You can use the same function into different methods. Okay, mainly use helper useful. Okay, helper useful for utility or some reuse the code. Okay, helper is also JavaScript function that can be called from another JavaScript. Then what is style? Style.css. Okay. Style.css, the main purpose is you can apply your custom CSS to your component. What is CSS? CSS is nothing but cascading style sheet. Okay. If you want to apply any style on your page, you have to be define your custom CSS. Everything you can do, okay, with this component, because of the Salesforce provide out of the box features, lighting design system, SLDS also provide. Okay, essentially if you want to apply SLDS or you want to apply tags or you want to build through CSS, in that case you have to be apply CSS, custom CSS. For example, I want to display my text in the specific color. Okay, instead of putting directly in your component, you can put the CSS here, there. You can use the CSS directly class in your component. Whatever styles apply here, you will get here, okay? Okay, you will get in your component. Okay, mainly style useful for apply any custom styles to your component. Okay, other than that, we have, okay, four more bundles are there. Document. What is this documentation? Documentation is mainly purpose of is to create any description, or you can put your code, or you can define your reference URL links. This is for future reference. Okay, these all are optionals only. Only the mandatory component is component bundle only. Okay, document is mainly the main purpose of to contain any description or to put any sample reference code, or you can define any URL and everything you can put into documentation. Then renderer is nothing but client side rendering to override default rendering. For example, okay, actually whenever you have load any particular page, you want to assign some value dynamically to your page. Okay, means actually you have to be override values. Okay, you can put your static values kind of thing. You can client side rendering to override default rendering, means actually you have to be define any some default values or anything you can put into rendering. Then design. What is design? Design is nothing but here. Okay, means actually you have to be design a form that enables business users. Means you can set the values to your component. For example, here, okay, you have one page to create particular account kind of thing. Okay, for example, here I want to define my account name, append with some different text kind of thing. Okay, you have to be set some value by default to your component using Lightning App Builder. Means here you have to be set it here. Okay, you have to be define your attributes into this design. Simple, you can define some attributes. That attributes you can define in your Lightning App Builder. Whenever you can add your App Builder, okay, whenever you have to be drag and drop your component, there you have to be define some values. For example, there will be a requirement like that. Whenever you create any particular account record, whoever logged in user, that username by default coming. Getting my point or not? Are you cutting my point? For example, you build one form. whenever you have opened the component, I want to display the current, okay, I want to display the current logged in user details by default. In this case here, you have to be defined some attribute, username, user email address kind of thing. You have to be defined some attribute. You have to be defined some attribute in your Lightning App Builder. Whenever you have opened your component, the value will be set automatically to your component. Okay, I will show you the real time actually how it works and everything. Then SVG. SVG is the final bundle. What is that means? You can apply your custom icons, custom logos. By default, Lightning Design System is already provide lot of logos. Other than that, if you want to define your brand icon logo kind of thing in your component or anything, you have to be put in your SVG, the color code and everything you can apply. You can get the particular icon from the SVG. SVG is nothing but custom icon resource. Clear? These all are about component bundle. Is it clear? Okay. Now here, let me quickly show you about bundles. Okay. Here actually, Lightning component bundle, right? Whenever you create any particular component other than bundle, we will get some options, right? Lightning tab, Lightning page, record page, Lightning community page, Lightning quick action. These all are different options are there, right? For example, whenever you check the checkbox of Lightning tab, okay, your component implement with app possible. See, we created one component, right? We simply checked the checkbox. We will get what interface? Force:app possible means whenever you create any component while creating any tab here in Salesforce. Okay. Just I want to show you quickly. Okay. There will be a Lightning component tab is there, right? If I click on new button, okay, you will see your component here. Why your component is displaying? Because you have defined this interface. Implements equal to force:app possible. For example, if I remove this interface, if I click on save, if I refresh the screen, are you get your component here? You will see. Are you get your component? No. Why? Because we removed the interface. If you want, okay, actually, if you want this component in your Lightning tab, okay, if you want to create a tab for this Lightning component, make sure you have to be define the interface. What is that? Force:app possible. This is implement is the keyword. You can define more than one interface with the comma separator. First checkbox, if you check this Lightning tab, okay, create a component for use as a navigation element in Lightning Experience. Means here you have to be add this component as a tab. Clear? Whenever you have checked this checkbox, Lightning page, okay, the Salesforce component, okay, Lightning component will create implement with flexi:page:available for all page states. Means your component using Lightning page or Lightning app builder. Means whenever you create any Lightning app builder page or anything, you have to be use this component in your Lightning app builder. Means you have to be use this component as the, under app. Make sure you have to be check this checkbox Lightning page. Or actually, if you want as a record page kind of thing, do you know? Detail page kind of thing, we already seen, right? Detail page. Okay. If you want to add this component under detail page, or you want to add as a record page kind of thing, make sure you have to be check this checkbox Lightning record page. Whenever you check this checkbox, here one more interface will be added here. Flexi:page:available for record home. Then here force:as-recorded means you will get the current record ID inside your component. Means create a component for use as a record home page in Lightning Experience. Means community, for example, okay, the Salesforce as separate concept is nothing but communities. If you want to get your component inside your community page, make sure you have to be check this checkbox. Whenever you check this Lightning community page, one more interface will be added here. Force:community:available for all page types. Whenever this interface will be there, then only you can add this component as under community. Okay, clear? These all are different interface will be there. We will go through that one by one, step by step. This this complete training will be happen in real time. Okay, there is no doubt on that. We will show you each and every example. Okay, this course only it will take 30 hour session. Within this lightning, we will cover the complete lightning along with okay. See SLDs concept and everything. Okay, other than that, we will cover integrations also. Okay, the lightning and integration. First of all, let me quickly show you. Okay, these all are tags, right? For example, here. I want to get some input text kind of thing. Input text. For example, here I want to add two numbers button. I want to display on it. We already seen the same example in our earlier Visual First Occasion development session. Now I will show you inside this lightning. For example, input is there, right? If you click on input, if you see here, these are different dates, right? These are some different some date structures. September 27. Are you have to be display like that? Are you want to display the read only date and time? Here some input time. Okay, you have to be display your time like that. Here color input. Okay, actually what color you want? The color code will be applicable automatically here. Okay. Here. File input, if you want get the file, simple, the tag name is lightning input, the name you can define type equal to file, this is a label. Okay, here text input, this is what text, this is what email, this is what password, number input. Okay, how you want to get your number, any dollar value, or you want to get any, okay, see, or you want to get any percentage, or you want any disabled number, or you want any read-only field, or you want to enter number like this, or you want to display the blank value to pass value to controller like this. Okay, for example, quickly I want to display two numbers. Okay, enter a number, just copy, then paste in your component, component one, component two. Okay, enter a number one, enter a number two. Just okay. Here, actually, if you want to display your component on your UI or anything, okay. Here, you have to be create a tab, okay. Or you want to display the UI kind of thing, you have to be add this component into somewhere, or you have to be create some application here. Okay, let me show you to create one application, because if I want to see output here, application lightning app here. Here, if you want UI or anything, here you have to be use extends. Force colon SLDS. Here, the preview. Preview means you have to be see output. If you want to see the component output, means you have to be make sure one app. Later we will see, we have to be add inside the component, inside your record page, or you have to be add into some app builder and everything we'll see. If you want add your component to this, okay, to this application, you have to be define your app. What is your app? What is your component? First component, right? You have to be put semicolon. Here, you simply add your component inside your app. If you want to see output of this one, you have to be click on preview. Preview means output. Enter number one and number two. Okay, here, I will create one button. How you can create button? To create any particular button, go to your lightning bundle. You have to be search for button. Button, button group, button icon. Button icon means you will get your button with icons. Okay. Button menu, button group, button like that. Here actually, this is what simple button. Here, what is the button? The tag is lightning button. Variant equal brand means actually you want to display the button in which format, in a neutral or brand, brand outline like that, brand. Label, label of the particular button. Then you have to be put any title. Title is optional, you can remove it. On click. On click is nothing but whenever you have to be click on particular button, okay? Okay, the event is fired from your JavaScript controller. Okay, for this component, if you can go to your component, this component is, okay, this is the controller, right? What is the controller? First component, controller. If you will observe here, whenever you create a controller, the component name, okay, there was some append with controller. If you can click on helper, the component name helper like that. If you click on style, the component dot css like that, different extension like that. See, whenever you have add any particular button, whenever you click on it, it will be called from the controller. Yeah, in this case here, no need to go any apex controller. You have to be handle the whole logic here itself. How we will see it. Okay, here let me add one button. It here. Okay, let me add one button. Just copy, then paste it here. One button. But here handle click is there, right? Okay, handle on click. Whenever you click on this particular button, you have to be raise some particular means, actually the call some function from the controller here by default. Okay, each and every controller helper by default create one function, my action here. Instead of my action, I will put my on click function name here. If you will observe here, if you, this is what, okay, see actually, okay, on click function by default, right? C dot, okay, c dot some handle click. Whenever you click on the particular button, okay, automatically the function call from your controller. We will see first of all to check any message or logs. First of all, you will see alert message. Alert means here, okay, here button click. I am displaying some message. Just a minute, guys. 1 minute. Sorry guys, here, okay, so let me show you, this is what output, right? Let me refresh it screen here. Let me save my component here. This is what start. Let me save it. Okay, if you can go to app, then click on update preview. Okay, here brand, right? If I click on particular button, what happened? There is a button click here. Means, okay, so if you are observe here, no need to go any apex controller. Whatever there, you can handle inside your JavaScript controller. Okay. Clear or not? Clear or not? Okay. You have to be handle everything. Okay. In our some regular session, how we can pass this particular input value to your controller, how we have to be handle the whole business logic by using this JavaScript controller, how we can define functions, okay, how we can define more than one interface, everything we will see in detail, okay, in our regular session. Okay, let me stop for today's class. Okay, let me open the course content, what it will cover in this particular Salesforce Lightning training. Okay, let me give some brief idea on it. Okay, in this training, okay, I will go through the complete real-time scenarios, real-time. Okay, I will show that you, okay, you can build your component by your own after completion of this, okay, after completion of this training. I will go with complete real-time hands-on training, this one. Okay, Lightning is very, very simple. You have to be, okay, you have to be build your component very easily, okay, very quickly. Okay. Okay, here actually these are about complete course content. Other than this, okay, actually, okay, other than this Lightning, I will give some end of the session. I will teach you integration also. I will cover integration also. Yeah, these are the, okay, again, see, lightning data service is one of the concept. What is lightning data service means? Means here, okay, without going your Apex controller, you can create your data. You have to be some update your records. You have to be delete your records by using lightning data service. Lightning event. Lightning some event is separate concept means, okay, you have to be transfer data from one component to another component. Okay, how you can send your data from one component to another component means by using events. Here some expression will be there. Expression is nothing but actually like in how you can get the value directly in your component, like some label or any, okay, actually, or you want to get any static resource images or anything. Here actually component IDs will be there, okay, local ID, global ID, and everything. Here, okay, some lightning tabs, app launcher, we already seen just a quick example of lightning tab, but I will give more overview on it. Means actually lightning controller, means actually how we can call Apex controller from your lightning component. What are the standard features we have to be follow? Okay, then we have to be see lightning design system. Lightning design system, I forgot to teach in this demo. Lightning design system. Lightning design system. Okay, if you see here, okay, these all are different features will be there, icons and everything. Here, for example, here, if you want to, these are the some icons. If you want to get this icon, you can simply use only one tag, you can get it. No need to write much code. Here, component blueprint is there. For example, here, if you want any badges kind of thing, these are the some HTML code kind of thing. Okay, the Salesforce lighting is already, these are what badges, right? Kind of thing. Badges. If you want to apply different color, different badges, you have to be apply the CSS. What is that means? Okay, the Salesforce Lightning is already built some HTML CSS. They will give some classes here. If you use this class, automatically it will change. Let me give one simple example. Okay, here I will create one div tag here. Div, you know, just here sample example. Okay, or actually I will put SV tag subname. Okay. Let me open this page once. SV text, right? Here actually, I want to apply this badge. What is that? SLDS badge. Here actually, you have to be use some class kind of thing. Do, right? Sorry, I will go to my component. These are the classes, means CSS classes. Class, you have to be put SLDS badge. Then you have to use one more badge, success badge. If we can copy, okay, save it, you can see the output, how it look like. You will get the badges here, right? Getting my point? No need to write any code. By using this out of the box, means actually, okay, by using this lightning design system, you have to be apply these styles. For example, here, if you want to display in warning, means actually, okay, some orange color, you have to be apply this CSS class. Warning. You can update view. You will see here. For example, you want to display this text into center kind of thing. You want to display in middle, right? Center. You have to be apply center. Align center something, right? Not align, even actually color also. For example, actually, if you want to display your color, some text right here, small size, you have to be apply. If you want to get your text in larger size kind of thing, you have to be copy and paste this style like this. Heading large, you can copy, then paste your CSS class. Here, no need to, just you have to be, no, copy paste, you have to be apply the CSS here, this class, you can copy. Then see this class, how it look like. The text size will be get increased. You have to be build your page with modern UI very quickly, very fast, no need to do anything. You have to be know about lightning design system as well as you have to know out of the box component. These are the okay. These are bundles. You have to be build your component very easily, very faster. No need to write much coding also. If you have to be go with Visual Postgres, okay, instead of writing 1,000 lines of code, you have to be doing 60-70 lines of code. You can build it. Okay, there is no much Apex coding. Everything you can handle through this client code. Okay, client side by using JavaScript controller and this particular Lightning design system. Okay, so let me stop for today's session. Okay, thanks everyone. Do you have any doubts or do you need any clarification?
Yes, sir. I am having one query.
Yes.
Yeah, my question is that in JavaScript, no?
Yes.
In Angular and JS, we need to write a different kind of code. So those things you will be covering in JavaScript, different style.
And yes, yes. Obviously, the thing is we will be cover JavaScript, then we will cover the CSS and everything. Okay.
So my question for this Lightning course, sir?
Sorry?
What is the duration for this course?
Duration, actually, it will take 30 hours.
Okay, so you are taking Monday to Sunday without taking any break, right? Continuously?
Yes, okay. Sometimes Saturday, Sundays also is there. If okay, the thing is, if you are flexible, okay, with weekend, then I will take class in weekend. Otherwise, Monday to Friday.
Okay, so hardly 3 weeks, 3 to 4 weeks it will take, right?
Yes, okay. Hardly like it will take 2.5 weeks like the daily 1.5 hour session.
Okay. And what about integration? How many hours you are going to cover for
integration? It will take some 5 hours like that. It will take.
So that rest and soap
yes, soap and rest. We will show you some real time examples also how it work and everything.
How will be preparing that?
Yes. That even actually the integration data how we can display in our Lightning component. For example, I think whenever you do integration, right, we will get some response. Okay. We'll get response in the form of JSON, right? How we can parse the data, how we can display inside our Lightning component.
Correct. This is calling out and calling in, but before that we need the setup is in place, right?
Yes. The integration setup and everything will be there. Once we have setup, then only we have to make call, right, from other system, right?
Okay.
Once we can make call, other system have data, right? We have to be get the data. Once we get data, how we have to be parse, how we have to display on the UI, right? Those will be covered.
And testing that call out by using the Postman and Workbench, that will be there, right?
You know. But here I will show you through workbench.developerpost.com only how we can test. Postman, everything is simple on the Postman. Also, if you want, I will show you. Just quickly, what we do, we have to be select. We need to be set the parameters. Then we click on submit, whether we get response or not.
Okay.
Postman, if you want to through Postman, SOAP UI, then Workbench, I will tell you. But, okay, teaching each and everything, it will be a separate lengthy process, right? I want quickly some overview about Postman, then SOAP UI tool, but I will show you how it works through Workbench. Then I will show you one real-time example, how we can make call out, okay? Then here, once we can get response, how we can pass, how we can show data within your Lightning component. Okay, without storing data into database. Okay. Now, do you have any other doubts?
No, that's it. I'm good, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Tomorrow? Not tomorrow. Planning to start the batch from Friday onwards. The regular batch. Hello. Can you hear me? Hello.
Yes, sir.
The regular batch will be starting from. Okay. Friday onwards. Yes.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay. Do you have any other talks?
No, I'm good, sir. I'm going to join Friday onwards.
Okay, sure. Yeah, fine. Okay. Do you have any doubts or anything? Please contact SV TechSupport. Okay. Yeah. Thanks, everyone. Okay. Let me stop for today's session. We'll be continuing. Okay. The Lightning batch from Friday onwards. Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.
So,